So today we're going to be looking at the used to, the verb used to, and to describe changes in the English language. So looking at these pictures, you can see that used to is used to describe changes from one part of one's life to another one. For example, I used to be small, now I'm big. I used to have short hair, now I have long hair. So used to is, even though it is part of the past, it's used to describe changes. For example, another one would be like, gas used to be $1.50, now it's $4.50. So it's the changes on the English language. Not particularly just staying in the past, but things that happen all the time that you no longer do. So if you used to have short hair, and now you have long hair, this is what currently is continuously happening. And this is just something that used to happen. I will leave it at that. And I could give sentences.
Okay, don't move. You've got an ideal situation here, but I think you've given them too much information. So just try it again. We'll take out the words on the board and just rely on the pictures, and then we'll take out. And so now we're just working on the visual information, and first of all we need to establish the vocabulary. So ask them questions about those pictures to establish the vocabulary.
Okay. So what do you see in this picture?
Good.
A small boy.
Okay, what do you see in this picture?
You see the difference? That's all. Now we've established that small and big are in the common sort of currency. We've checked that they know those. And do the same with the second picture.
Okay.
Just do that. So. Okay. And here.
That's the advantage of ashes, is that a kip is readily replaced by
mistakes. So let's say, let's go run back a bit and just using it with smoke. So ask your questions, Marcos, with smoke.
Ask the questions, okay. So, what do you see in this picture?
Good.
Smoking.
Okay, what do you see in this picture?
No smoking.
Okay, so what can you tell me about this
fantastic
picture?
Fantastic.
She's smoking, okay. So what else can you say about it? She stopped smoking. Does she still? I mean,
yes.
Does she still smoke?
No.
She used to.
There we go. She used to.
I know she did, but she's helping you out. But if she didn't, what are they likely to say?
She smoked.
And then what?
Yeah,
and then what do you ask them? This is the key point.
Obviously she smoked in the past. Great. So it happened. What's another way of saying?
What do we need to distinguish between she smoked?
Did she smoke one time in the past?
Okay. So did she smoke more than once?
Probably.
More than twice?
Probably.
More than three times?
Every day.
So we can say she smoked every day. Okay.
You got them there. Now, okay, so if it doesn't come, then you can say, okay, we've established she smoked every day, we've established it was a habit, because we aren't. Brilliant. Okay, well done. Give them a round of applause.